Welcome to part 1 of Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. You are going to learn how to open a new Gmail account, how to create and set up a Blogger site in this video. You may skip to each timestamp if you know how to set up these things already. Since this is a full tutorial series, I will show the steps by steps to set up a simple Blogger site and get Google AdSense approval. Let's dive in right now. Step 1. Create a Gmail account. Open your Google Chrome browser. On the right upper side, click the blue button with Sign In. In this Sign In page, click Create Account down here. Select Create Account for yourself. Simply fill in any name, regardless if it is a real or fake name, and choose your username aka your Gmail address. Then fill in the passwords. Press Next if Google asks you to verify your phone number, key in here. After that, press Next to move on to the next page. Fill in the code Google sends to your phone to complete verification. It is optional to fill in a recovery email, you can fill in or not as you like. If you don't want to put your real birthday and gender, it is okay, and it wouldn't affect your AdSense approval. But if you are less than 18 years old, you have to register an AdSense account under the name of your parents or guardians. It is not included in part 1 of BAT series, but I will cover it up later, so press Next and let's move on now. Free to choose between Skip or Yes, I'm in. Then scroll down to the last row and click I agree. So now a Gmail account is created. You can open multiple Gmail accounts using a phone number, but each publisher can only have one AdSense account according to AdSense policies. Since I already have an AdSense account that was registered with the phone number I just used. Therefore, I want to remove this phone number before I create another AdSense account. To remove this phone number, click the icon on the upper right side. Press Manage your Google account. Click Personal Info. Click Phone under Contact Info. Click here and press the dustbin icon. Log in again and press the dustbin icon another time to remove the phone number. So now I have removed it, let's move on to the next part of this tutorial, which is how to create a Blogger site. On this Google page, search Blogger. Click on the first result under blogger.com. Then press Create your blog. Choose the Google account and log in. Choose either one to continue, I choose to add my area name. After that, you have to choose a name for your blog. Then you have to choose the URL of your blog. Try to write something short, catchy and easy to type, or you can try to type any name within 6 to 12 characters. Lastly, write your display name, it's just like a username, and press Finish. Now a new Blogger site is created, let me manage tracking my own page views here, so that Blogger will not include my views on this blog. Click here to view the blog, and this blog URL is verioex.blogspot.com. The name of my blog is at here, and the display name is at here. Click View Profile, and you can edit your profile here. Back to the Blogger dashboard, let me briefly introduce these sections on the Blogger sidebar. The first one is Posts, this is where you publish your content, articles and posts. Stats is the place to see the number of views on your site, your latest posts, all your posts and pages. Comments is the place where you manage all the comments on your site, you can approve or delete some spams comment with unverified links using the Manage button here. The Earnings tab is the place where you can create or open a Google AdSense account, but I will show it in another video of this Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. Pages is similar to posts, but it is for static content or pages like About Me, Contact Me, Privacy Policy, etc. Layout is the place to edit the design of your blog, you can add, remove or adjust widgets here by changing the layout. Theme is the place you can select the appearance of the Blogger site. Currently I'm using the simple template provided by Blogger, and I'm going to use this theme to get Google AdSense approval. Settings is where you can customize a blog by changing domain name, user's permission, visibility on Google search, etc. Under Basic here, fill in the description with less than 500 characters to let your users know what your blog is about. For example, Verioxx is all about SOA actuarial exams, Blogger, and Google AdSense. The default language on this blog is English. Disable both sections under Adult Content. Tutorial to set up Google Analytics and create a favicon will be mentioned in latter part of this BAT series. Favicon is the logo of your site showing in the tab here, and you can see the description is below Verioxx now. You have to ensure your blog is visible to search engines, or else how Google can crawl and index your site. You can purchase and place custom domain here, but I will use .blogspot.com to get Google AdSense approval. Don't believe anyone who says you need a custom domain to get AdSense approval, as this claim is totally false. Also, you have to enable HTTPS here. You can invite someone to publish or manage this Blogger site here, or even change the reader access. Set reader access to the public in order to get Google AdSense approval later. You can change the maximum posts shown on the main page here, the default is 7, and the remaining is not that important. You can manage who viewers leave comments on your blog here, I always moderate comments to prevent spam on my site. Email section is not important to get Google AdSense approval, leave it as default. Time zone is also not that important, but you can change to the settings you like. I encouraged you to enable meta tags, because meta tags are part of the HTML tags that describe your page content to search engines and website visitors. The search description down here is the place you describe your blogger site, so mention some keywords in here. Like my case is some SOA exams. Besides, custom 404 is not compulsory, but you can simply design it. There is no use of custom redirects here to get Google AdSense approval. For this crawlers and indexing section, there are many tutorials that tell you to enable custom robots.txt or robots.headers tags. My suggestion is don't enable these custom things. I know you have doubts on why I should not enable them, just don't. Because this blogger site already has a functional robots.txt after its creation, so don't waste your time to change it anymore. By typing /robots.txt behind blog URL, you can now look at the original robots.txt. Blogger already set up a robots.txt file, so don't ever change it anymore. Same as robots.txt, don't enable custom ads.txt. You can import, download, or remove your blog under Manage Blog section. Normally, I wouldn't use this section, but I will back up content before making tremendous adjustments on my blog. Nothing is important down here, and that's all how to simply create and set up a blogger site. Feel free to ask me something in comment section if you still have any doubts about blogger creation and setup. I'm going to talk about the steps-by-steps tutorial to set up Google Search Console and Google Analytics in next video and show you how to connect both GSC and Analytics to blogger site. Click here to watch next part of BAT series or this watch list to learn more about Google AdSense. Goodbye and have a nice day.